Leafcutter ants are special. They're the only ones that are actually insect farmers.
Visitors to the Canadian Museum of Nature enjoy seeing the displays of live animals. Recently, the museum revamped its popular exhibit of live insects. Bugs Alive now features an impressive leafcutter ant colony. The ants may be small, but if you look close, you'll discover a fascinating and organized society. They are called the farmers of the insect world, as their lives are devoted to cultivating a crop of fungus to feed their larvae.
Leafcutter ants occur in the tropical parts of the Americas, from the southern United States down into South America. There's about 40 species. Leafcutter ants are unique in the ant world in that they are the only ants that grow a fungus on the leaf substrates that they bring back to their nest. Most other ant groups are predators or scavengers, or go out and find dead insects, or in some cases live insects in the case of army ants, and bring them back to the nest as food for the young. But leafcutter ants are special. They're the only ones that are actually insect farmers.
We got this ant colony from an entomologist. His name is Ryan Garrett. He raised these ants, which are leafcutter ants, for the museum for us to put on display. The ant display is a custom designed and built ant habitat, and you can watch the ant go from foraging through the highway system and all the way to the orb, and where they hand it off to another ant to bring inside of their nest. So each one of the orbs contains a fungus garden, and inside of the fungus garden is where the larva and a lot of the ants live. They all work in there. They manage the fungus. They keep the fungus happy by bringing the cut leaves into the fungus and inserting it into the fungus. In turn, the fungus digests the leaves to grow, and in turn, then the ants have a food source. There's only one queen for this colony, and the queen is located in the largest orb. She's very difficult to spot because she's usually covered in other ants, or she's inside of the fungus chamber laying eggs. The first time seeing the queen was quite an impressive sight. In comparison, if a person was a worker ant, an elephant would be the size of the queen. She's huge.
There's a number of different castes in the leafcutter ant colony, and it's based on the size of the individuals. There can be very tiny individuals which ride on the leaves and protect the leaves from being attacked by any parasites. Then there are what are called minor workers, which would do the job of cutting and carrying the leaves. These individuals have very sharp mandibles that they use to cut off portions of the leaves that they then carry back to the nest. Then there are major individuals, which we would call simply soldiers, that have huge jaws, huge heads with muscles that that operate those mandibles, that guard the columns of the millions of ants that are bringing back pieces of leaf to the nest. Of course, there's also the queen, lives sequestered somewhere in the middle of the colony in a special chamber, and it is her that produces all the eggs that make that colony survive. On trips I've taken to the tropics, I've seen a leafcutter ant nest, and for meters around that nest entrance point, there will be no vegetation growing. The ants have stripped all the leaves off the trees and little low shrubs surrounding the nest.
When I go to a country with leafcutters, I want to collect them to bring them back for research or for exhibitry. The farmers in the countries where I visit are never upset to have some of their leafcutter ant colonies dug up. So usually I bring the queen and somewhere in the order of hundreds or low thousands of ants and a small fungus garden. And then I get them into my lab and give them humidity and temperature that they really like. But once they really get a good footing and they get enough workers, the growth is sort of unfathomable.
Intelligence takes many different forms in the natural world. The leafcutter ant's incredible ability to farm sustainably and build underground structures that rival human constructions in their proportional scale and complexity makes them a true wonder of the natural world.